That Hinako foodgasm face, dude. Oh my god, that Chibi Inumi foodgasm face. That got me. That's my favorite one alongside Hishoko. Out of the females, for sure. Those two. Dojima definitely won for the males, but oh my god, this one was amazing, dude. If you know what I'm talking about, every week during Spice, during the E-Day, they change out one key illustration and, you know, have different characters with these chibi foodgasm faces. If you've been missing out on those, you need to go back and look at them because they're awesome, dude. Oh my god, that you got me. But Shokugeki no Soma, episode 11. My boy Soma is in the kitchen alongside my best girl Megumi, putting in work against the grand magician of legumes, the mage of France, you know, the gourmet king in Paris, Shino motherfucking Mia, the OG, going in the Shokugeki, dude. And I gotta put my fuck Shino Mia face on because, like I said last week, I'm caught up on the manga. I fucks with Shinomiya. I really like Shinomiya's character. Shinomiya Shisho is dope, okay? But right now, I gotta recede back. Like, I don't know the events that transpire. I gotta be like you. I gotta get that fuck Shinomiya mentality. But nobody can doubt that he's going in. He turned Dojima into little pink cabbage bitch, dude. Did you see that? Like, I remember this foodgasm in particular because I was like, what the fuck is happening, right? With the magical cabbage, and he's like, cabbage pink. I'm like, Dojima, dude. But you just see the effects of the man's food. They took it to a new level in this episode. JC staff, man, you took that foodgasm to the next level, dude. With the alumni just going in, forming some, you know, pseudo sailor scout type thing off of the cabbage magic and everything. Like, you had the one dude in the tuxedo mask cosplay. I'm just like, yo, I forgot how fucking ridiculous this is. The magician of legumes, it seems like an insurmountable task, many will think. This, though, is a key moment in the progression of the series where Megumi starts to come into her own. Yes, it seems insurmountable. I don't want to spoil anything. Dude, I want to know who believes that Megumi can actually transcend this, because, you know, she was the lead chef on this. And I love the way Dojima said it and spun it. Like, he's the one, and you see the power of Dojima throughout this episode, where Shinomiya is like, I'm not doing that shit. And he's like, accept the challenge. And he's just like, all right, you see that force, how much weight Dojima carries just because of that interaction, and knowing Shinomiya, being a former first seat, is looking up to this man who is also a former first seat, and there's a gap that large that shows you the power scale of this series. But that's neither here nor there, right? I like how he's like, what are you gonna do? Why wouldn't I make Megumi the head chef? Are she, every time, you know, this school is about getting by on your own merit. If she can't do it now, she's gonna get herself into this same situation. What is she gonna do? Ride your coattails for the rest of this time? You gonna keep saving her, Soma? And I agree with that. As harsh as it sounds, this is where Megumi comes into role. This is my best girl, don't get me wrong. And seeing her put in this situation, like, the feels, it just takes me back to when I read it in the manga, dude. I'm just like, yo, this asshole is fucking with her right now. How are you gonna do this, Shinomiya? How are you gonna fucking do this? After she tried her hardest, and seeing her freeze up and see that wall, that insurmountable challenge in front of her, and Soma, just that interaction. He's like, just focus on your own cooking. And that they do that little technique that he came up where she slaps her hands to get rid of the nervousness and everything. I'm like, this is so fucking kawaii, dude. This is dope. And to see the progression of this episode, you also see the alumni that are the judges. I love the fucking, speaking of Hinako, dude, fucking Inui, I love the interactions between Inui and Shinomiya, dude. I forgot how great it is. Just, oh my goodness. Just seeing, like, how she, you know, teases him at all points, and especially how she treats Megumi. But on top of that, you know, how Shinomiya responds with just, you know, complete annoyance or violence. I'm just like, yo, this is hilarious. But either way, we got the Shokugeki going in. Shinomiya comes with a crazy dish, alright? You see the power of it right now. And Megumi's trying to compete with the magician of legumes on his level, as you see with her dish post credits. And all she had to do, Soma brought out, you know, the best in her through a more supportive role this time, where he's like, you know, focus on your own cooking, you can do this, believe in yourself, those onigiri you made us were amazing, blah, 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 you know? And on top of that, you see him, you know, bringing out her cooking ability by being an amazing sous chef, and you know that, you know, the rest of the alumni can see Yukihira's potential and how great his skill is. They're watching him, you know, be one step ahead of Megumi time and time again in this preparation process, and they're like, yo, this is a gem. We found a fucking gem, and they're looking, and he's like, the one dude says it, I forget his name, this one alumni, he's basically like, this is above any student level. Like, he is above, that's that god level Yukihira shit. That is where Soma's at right now. Yes, there's a bunch of crazy people in this universe. Yes, there's definitely people whose skill is far above Yukihira at this point. But he's a fucking magician in the kitchen, dude. And I feel that nobody, you know, nobody can, I don't want to spoil anything, but nobody can believe that Megumi and Soma are going to be expelled here, you know? But at the same time, this task, this man that they're facing right now is godly. So I just want to know what people's thoughts are. How do you feel about Megumi at this part? This should be the time. After this, if you haven't, you know, considered Megumi for your best girl at this point in this series, after this, this should be the time where she truly shines for you, dude. And she only gets better. I promise you that. She only gets better. There are a lot of great girls in this series, but she's been in my top three for a minute. So that's pretty much it for this episode. Need to get on the episode reviews. I mean, on the chapter reviews. Need to talk about the character poll, because there was one gripe I had with the character poll that I need to talk about. But this episode, dude. Oh, and the Spiceful ED is out. You guys gotta cop that, because that is one of my favorite EDs for the season. It's so fucking catchy, dude. It's so catchy. But yeah, that's pretty much it, dude. The Shokugeki's going in. Can't wait for next week's episode. I just love how JC staff is handling this series and how they're adapting it, the pacing, the animation, you know, just how quirky it is and how lively it is and everything. It's just, it's nice, dude, how they're bringing out certain aspects of it even more so than the manga. Of course, you know, there's things that the manga did better in certain scenarios as well, but they're really bringing out things, foreshadowing certain things early and, you know, paying due respect and adapting it pretty perfectly. So that's pretty much it. Let me know your thoughts on this episode of That Soma Greatness, and I'm out. Peace.